Good morning, students. Today we are going to see workshop of the story The Fall of Troy part 2. In this video we are going to see questions and answers. Question number 1. How did the Greeks enter the city of Troy? Answer. Odysseus devised a clever plan which helped the Greeks enter the city of Troy. A huge wooden horse was built such that the best of the Greek fighters could hide inside. The horse was left on the shore with one of the Greek soldiers, who told them that he escaped from being offered to the sea god. Question number 2. Do you think that the Greeks would have won without Odysseus' plan? Answer. No. The Greeks would not have won without the cunning plan devised by Odysseus. The war had been going on for 10 years. Some of the greatest warriors, including Achilles, Paris, and Hector, were killed, yet the war did not end. The Greeks failed to take the city while the Trojans could not force them to sail away. Sometimes the Trojans had the better of it, and sometimes the Greeks, but still the fighting went on. Question number 3. How did the Greek ships remain hidden from Troy? Answer. The Greek ships remained hidden from Troy by lowering their sails and dropping their anchors behind an island away from the coast. Next question. What distressing sounds and sight could be witnessed at Troy that fateful night? Answer is. Troy was filled with the sight of leaping flames as the Greeks had set fire to the houses, temples, towers, and palaces. There were sounds of people shouting and the noise of weapons and cries of weeping women. Such were the distressing sounds and sights that could be witnessed at Troy on that fateful night when the whole city was burnt to ashes. Next question. What was the destiny of the royal family of Troy and that of Helen? Answer. The royal family of Troy was destined to be defeated by the Greeks, and hence, even after defending itself for 10 years, it was defeated in the end. Hector, Paris, and old King Priam with all his sons were killed. Hector's wife, mother, and sister were carried off as slaves by the Greeks. Helen was destined to be back with her husband. So, after the defeat of the Trojans, she returned back to Greece with her husband. Next question. Do you think the Greeks and Trojans were superstitious? Give reasons for your answer. Answer is, the Greeks were not superstitious, as the huge wooden horse was not an offering to the sea god, but a clever trick. The Trojans, on the other hand, were superstitious, as they believed in the fake story of the only Greek who was left behind. The Trojans really thought that if they got the wooden horse inside their city, they would be blessed by the sea god. And so, they even tore down a part of the wall and to drag the horse in, risking the security of their own city. Next question. How could the fall of Troy have been avoided? Answer. The fall of Troy could have been avoided only if the people of Troy had paid heed to the warning of their priest. The Greeks might have never been able to enter the city if the huge wooden horse with the soldiers hiding inside it was not dragged into the city. And if they hadn't broken down a part of their own walls, which had protected the city for so many years. Next question. How did Odysseus plan to defeat the Trojans? Answer. Odysseus planned to build a huge wooden horse so that the best fighters can hide inside it, while the rest of the army will pretend to have sailed back only to return back to the shore at night to kill the Trojans when they would be asleep. Next question. What was the reason for Troy to rejoice and celebrate? Answer. The reason for Troy to rejoice and celebrate was that the war was over and the long siege had ended. Next question, how were epics transmitted from generation to generation? Answer, epics were transmitted from generation to generation orally as over a period of many years. They were handed down from singer to singer till perhaps one great poet gave them their final form. Next question, who are considered to be the authors of epics Ramayana and Mahabharata respectively? Answer, Ramayana is written by Valmiki and Mahabharata is written by Ved Vyas. And last question is, why is Homer honored with the title Father of European Poetry? Answer, Homer is a blind poet who lived about 900 BC, wandered from one Greek city to village, one Greek city or village to another, singing his poems. It is believed that the Iliad and Odyssey were composed and recited by Homer, and so he is honored through the ages, not only in Greece but in all Europe, as the father of European poetry. In this way, we have seen some questions and answers from part 1 and part 2. Students, you must write these all questions and answers in your classwork. Thank you.